Halo anak-anak, good morning everybody. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Well, this morning, this is English lesson. So, I want to greet you first. How are you? I hope you are fine. And just like me now. Okay, everybody. In this occasion or in this day, so we are going to continue our lesson. But in this time, it is not about the lesson, but we discuss about the test. Yeah. So, Miss Dida will give you some kind of test, but not like we discuss together about the test, and then we can check your answer and we will discuss together about the test and we know about the answer of this question. Okay, yeah. In this time, we still continue about simple present tense. So, we discuss about simple present tense and descriptive tense. Last time, we have discussed about this simple present tense and descriptive tense, but now we continue again about this one. It means that you will get better. Okay? Jadi kita lanjutkan lagi dengan membahas soal, kemudian bagaimana caranya how to do the test. So you can get the right answer, right? Sehingga kamu bisa mendapatkan jawaban yang benar. Itu seperti apa? Kita diskusi bareng-bareng ya. Oke. This one is about simple present tense ya. First, langsung kita jawab. Nah, sebelumnya, before it, I hope you to open your exercise book and then state the date and then what kind of text that you want to discuss. Jadi kamu tulis di situ hari apa, tanggal berapa sekarang ini, kemudian ditambah apa yang mau dibahas apa, yaitu soal tentang simple present tense dan descriptive tense. Okay. Now, are you ready? Udah siap semuanya? Baik. Pastikan dulu. Saya ingatkan ya bahwa apa kalian harus sudah absen dulu loh ya, yang tadi sudah absen. Kemudian tadi pagi udah absen kan? Ini absen lagi untuk yang bahasa Inggris. Okay. Kita mulai ya. Let's start now. Untuk simple present tense, kalian ini masih ingat ya apa yang kemarin di benak kalian. Simple present tense itu kata kerjanya yang dipakai kata kerja bentuk berapa? Satu. Kata kerja bentuk satu itu kalau yang menggunakan subjeknya he, she, it, they, we, I, he, she, it, itu kata kerjanya ditambah dengan s. Sedangkan kalau yang they, we, I, you, kata kerjanya tidak menggunakan s. Well, do you understand? Do you still remember that? Okay. Number one. Choose the correct answer of the question below. Number one, ya. She doesn't blah 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 to the dentist every month. Apa kira-kira jawabannya? Go, goes, going, atau gone? Kata kerja bentuk asli ditambah s ditambah ing, ini bentuk kedua. Kira-kira jawabannya apa? Kalau sudah tahu rumusnya berarti kalian gampang untuk mengerjakannya. Apa coba? Kamu lihat kalimat di sini. Di sini ada apa? Setelah subjek ada dasen. Apa nih maksudnya dasen? Dasen itu adalah kalimat menunjukkan bahwa itu kalimatnya negatif. Lalu apa yang dipakai di sini ini menunjukkan adalah kata kerja bantu. Jadi kalau kalimat itu ada kata kerja bantunya, maka yang dipakai di sini nanti jawabannya adalah kata kerja bentuk satu. Bentuk satu itu yang gimana? Kata kerja bentuk satu itu kata kerja yang asli, tidak ditambah dengan apapun juga. Baik ya? Oke. Jadi kalau di sini ada dasen, berarti jawabnya apa? Ada pembantunya, berarti nanti kata kerjanya bentuk satu. Yang mana? Go, goes, going, or gone. Apa? Yang asli adalah go. Jadi, number one, the answer is A. The answer is go. So, she doesn't go to the dentist every month. Okay, good. Now, number two. The children always blah 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 up late in the morning. Anak-anak itu selalu. Nah, kata selalu ini menunjukkan kebiasaan toh, kebiasaan. Jadi, simple present tense itu menunjukkan kegiatan yang rutin, kegiatan rutinitas. Jadi, kata kerjanya apa nanti, ya? Kalau ini adalah always itu menunjukkan kebiasaan, maka ini menunjukkan bahwa ini ciri daripada simple present. Nah, sekarang seperti yang Mr. Dar tadi bilang ya, just like what I said to you first, that there is look at the subject. Jadi kalau subjeknya di sini adalah children, children itu adalah anak-anak. Anak-anak itu gimana? Lebih dari satu. Pronounnya apa? They. Maka kalau they, subjeknya they, masih ingat they, we, I, you. Maka they itu kata kerjanya pakai S enggak? Kalau they, we, I, you enggak suka S ya. Jadi they, we, I, you itu tidak pakai S. Maka they di sini mana yang tidak pakai S? Mana yang tidak pakai S? Ada wakes, ada wake, ada woke, ada awake. Wakes itu Anda pakai S, salah. Wake ini benar kata kerja bentuk 1, woke itu kata kerja bentuk 2, awake itu adalah terbangun, bukan. Jadi jawabnya adalah B. Ya, jadi the children always wake up late in the morning. Okay? Good. Next, number 3. Tommy bla 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 the books to the bookshop. Well, nah, sekarang kerjakan sendiri ya, coba. Nanti setelah itu sampai dengan semuanya, nanti kamu bisa cek setelah mengerjakan. Kemudian nanti akan saya beri jawaban. Kemudian kamu cek betul berapa nanti ya. Betul berapa, coba nanti ditulis di buku pekerjaan and the exercise book. Oke ya. Good, nah number 3. Let me read first ya. Tommy bla 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 the books on the bookshop. So the answer is carry. Be carrying, carries or carried. Number 4. Does your sister bla 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 you in the kitchen every day? Yo, ini gimana? Ini ada kata pembantunya enggak? Ada apa? Does tadi masih ingat ya? Jawabannya apa? Oke, helping, helps, help, atau help. Good, number 5. Do you usually blah 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 breakfast every day? Oke, has, have, hold, had, or having. Number 6. Sorry. We always English with our teacher in the study room. The answer is studying, studies, studied, or study. Number 7. The school bla 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 at 7 in the morning. Sekolah itu dimulai jam 7 di pagi hari every day except Sunday, kecuali hari Minggu. Now, starting or started. Now, number 8. I often, saya sering ya, sering bla bla bla, biographies of the Indonesian heroes. I often jadi membaca biografi heroes, you know heroes, heroes itu adalah pahlawan Indonesia. Jadi membacanya yang benar, read, read, reading, or road. Good number 9. Mr. Gading, bla bla bla, met at a primary school. Ya. So, the answer is T. Jadi Mr. Gading mengajar matematika at the primary school. Ya. Jadi di sini ada teach, teaches, teaching, or taught. Nah, number 10. The student sometimes, nah ini sometimes ini kadang-kadang ya, kadang-kadang anak-anak itu bla 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 the museum visit, nah jadi mengunjungi museum. Nah di sini jawabnya visited, visits, visiting, or visit, or visits ya. Okay, now do you understand? Okay, please do it. And the exercise book number 1 to number 10 about simple present tense. Next. Nah, sekarang cerita about now. It's about descriptive test. Apa cerita apa deskriptif? Mendeskripsikan sesuatu, bisa orang, bisa benda, bisa juga binatang. Nah, kemarin sudah ya. Ini melanjutkan aja. Coba kalian nanti bisa jawabannya apa. Sama. Miss Tidar will lead you first how to answer about this question. Let's we know about the text first, okay? Text 1. Jadi nanti ada bacaan, kemudian kamu jawab ya. Read the following text to answer the question number 1 to 4. Oh, sorry. Number 1 to 4. Jadi nomor 1 ini kurang ya, kurang kata 1. Number 1 to 4. Most people in the world have a pet. Jadi banyak kebanyakan orang di dunia ini mempunyai binatang peliharaan. I also have it. Saya juga punya. My pet is a dog. Petku adalah anjing. Named Miko. Name is, ini is ya sebenarnya. Oke ya. Namanya adalah Miko. Its color is brown. Warnanya coklat. It has brown eyes too. Ya. Apa? It has brown eyes too. You know eyes? Mata. Jadi matanya juga brown. I got this pet from my friend at the beginning of 2009. Saya mendapatkan pet itu from my friend at the beginning, di awal tahun sekian, 2009. He brought it from a pet shop. Dia belinya dari pet shop, toko pet ya, binatang peliharaan, in this country, di negara ini. Once a week itu artinya once itu sekali, once a week, seminggu sekali, my brother baths him itu adalah bath, I take a bath, berarti saya mandi ya. Kalau my brother baths him berarti saudara laki-lakiku atau adikku laki-laki atau kakakku apa bath him, memandikannya ya. He is funny and smart. Siapa yang funny and smart? Iya, funny ya, lucu dan pintar. It often plays with my neighbor's dog. Ya, biasanya atau sering main dengan dognya siapa? Neighbor itu tetangga. I love him very much because he can be my friend too. Oh, saya senang banget karena dia juga bisa menjadi temanku. Well, they understand. Now come to the question. Okay, remember, let's write on your exercise book from number 1 to number 10. Okay, ya, from the descriptive text. Answer this question below based on the text. Number one. Sorry, this is number one ya. Miko eyes are bla bla bla. Nah, masih ingat ya. Matanya Miko itu kayak apa? Warnanya. Black, white, brown, and dark brown. Do you understand? Good. Number two. The writer got the pet from. Nah, penulis tadi mendapatkan got pet from. Dari siapa? From his neighbor, a pet shop, his friend, or his mother. Number three. What is the text about? Teks itu tentang apa? Teksnya tadi. Okay. My lovely dog, my best friend, my pet shop, or his mother. Number four, I also have it. I also have it. Saya juga punya. The underline word, aduh kurang word nih ya. Apa yang di garis bawah ini refers to? Yang di garis bawah ini mengacu pada apa? Okay. Pet, people, the word, or the writer. Do you understand text one and the question? And I hope you can do this very well. Okay, ya? Good, next. Number five. Well, number five, we have the text too. Okay, ya? Now, let's see about the text source. I just got a new toy from my uncle. Sorry, this is my, not mu ya. This is my. I got a new toy from my uncle. My uncle, saya dapatkan new toy. Apa tuh toy? Mainan ya. Mainan. New toy itu adalah mainan baru. From my uncle. My uncle is a sailor. You know, sailor. Sailor itu adalah pelaut. Jadi, uncleku adalah sailor ya. He bought me robot when he sailed abroad. Dia membelikan membawaku ya, membawakanku robot ketika dia he sailed abroad. Dia ketika berlayar di luar negeri. I love this robot. Saya suka robot itu. My robot is very nice. It is about 20 cm tall. Robotnya bagus ya. Menyenangkan. Tingginya sekian. Berapa? 20 cm. And the color of robot is blue. Warnanya ini. The robot has a strong body. Ya, punya strong body, it has two big red eyes. It's two strong leg are covered with blade bolts. Jadi, badannya strong kuat, matanya merah, kemudian punya kaki yang kuat yang dibalut dengan blade boot, jadi sepatu. My robot can be moved with two medium-sized batteries. Jadi robot itu dapat bergerak dengan menggunakan baterai yang berukuran medium. After inserting the batteries at the back of the robot body, we can make it move when we push the button behind its neck. Nah, what is it? Jadi setelah memasukkan insert itu masukkan toh after insert the batteries memasukkan baterai di at the back of the robot's body di badan dari robot di sebelah belakangnya kemudian we make it move jadi membuat itu bergerak ketika kita we push the button. Bisa bergerak ketika kita menekan tombol yang berada behind its neck yang berada di di belakangnya leher ya neck itu leher. The robot will move its left and right foot in turn. Jadi robot itu akan bergerak ke kiri ke kanan nah and foot intern. Dan berulang kali ya, apa bolak-balik gitu. Nah, it will move its two arm in turn two. It will move its two arm. Arm, you know arm, jadi menggerakkan ini apa sih namanya, lengan, apa namanya, bahu, in turn two. Dan bergerak juga, akan tetapi however the robot could not, tidak bisa bend it, jadi membungkukkan feet kakinya, melipat kakinya. It move forward only. Oke, ya. Kemudian jawabnya number 5, what are the color of robot eyes? Apa warnanya tadi robot eyes-nya? Kemudian next number 6, what is the main idea of paragraph 3? Apa? Paragraph 3, 1 2 3. Nah, di sini nih. What is the main idea? Pokok pikiran utamanya apa di paragraf 3 ini? Ya, a medium size batteries must be put make the robot strong. The batteries are needed to make the robot move. The lightest robot is difficult to move. The robot can move without batteries. Number 7. From the text we know that, dari teks itu kita bisa tahu bahwa the robot can move backward, nggak bisa bergerak ke belakang. The robot's feet are bendable, bendable. Robot feet, kakinya itu are bendable, dapat dibengkokkan. The robot can move at all, robot itu nggak bisa bergerak sama sekali. The robot has no arm, robotnya nggak punya bahu ini ya. Okay, I hope you understand about text too well. Do it well, ya. Yeah? Number 8. Ya, yeah, number 8, but the text-nya kebalik ya. Maaf, kita lihat the text 3 first. Nah, ini kebalik ini. Text 3, ini cerita tentang apa sekarang? The Jogja kembali. Oh, cerita tentang Jogja kembali. Monumen, ya itu apa? Monumen Jogja kembali. The Jogja kembali monument is located in Yogyakarta. It is 3 kilometers north of the Jogja city center in Jonggang village of the Sleman Regency, di daerah Sleman ya. The monument was inaugurated on June 29, 1985, to commemorate the historic Indonesian struggle of independence. Jogja kembali means Jogja returns, kembali Jogja ya, as a reminder of the returning of Indonesian Republic government. There are two sections of the Jogja Kembali Monument. The first section of the touring aircraft is on the eastern gate, while the eastern section of Gentai aircraft stand closer the western entrance of the monument. The monument has two wheeled machine guns which can be seen from a podium toward the eastern and the western side. In the southern end of the yard, there is a wall engraved with 420 names of freedom fighters who lost their life during a great struggle. From December 1948 to June 29, 1949. A poem by Khairil Anwar titled Karawang Bekasi is written on one side of the wall dedicated to these unknown patriots. Jogja Kembali Monument is surrounded by First Pond. It divided into four alleys which lead to the main building. The main building consists of different floors, displaying a wide range of collection during and after the war times. It shows dioramas, carved reliefs, or collection of clothes and weapons. Jadi cerita tentang apa Jogja Kembali Monumen, di mana letaknya, kemudian ada apa di sana, kemudian di lokasinya di situ ada apa saja dan seterusnya ya. Jogja Kembali itu dikelilingi oleh apa? Kolam ikan misalnya begitu dan seterusnya. Itu menggambarkan apa? Bahkan ada sebuah ada puisi dari Chairil Anwar yang tertera di situ, yang berjudul Karawang Bekasi, tertulis di side wall of dedicated of this unknown patriot. Well, okay, now come to the question number. Yes. Nah, this is the text and then this is the question. The question number 8, what can be found in the western entrance of the monument? Apa yang kita temukan di pintu masuk sebelah barat monument? Apa tadi ya, the two-wheel machine guns, a replica of Kuntai aircraft, a replica of Churang aircraft, or a wall engraved with 420 names of freedom fighters? Okay, next, number 9. What is the topic of the text above? Topiknya apa tuh tadi teks itu? Yogyakarta, the Kuntai aircraft, the Jogja Kembali monument, the history of Indonesia struggle. I think it's easy for you to do it. Now, number 10. From the text above, we can conclude that. Jadi bisa mengkonklusi, bisa menyimpulkan tentang teks di atas apa? Coba. 1. The collection during and after the war displayed outside the building. B. The Jogja Kembali Monument is surrounded by the first pond. Yang C. The dioramas can be seen in one of the four alleys. And D, the main building has only one floor. Well, do you understand? Okay. I think it's easy for you to do that. Yes? And don't forget, check again your answer. And then after finish, next I will give you the answers, and then you can check it, and then please you can give the score to me, how many score. So there are 20 questions, 10 from the simple present tense and then 10 from the descriptive text, so there are 20. Then after it, please give me, send to me, how many score that you got it. Okay, yeah. Thank you. And good luck, yeah. Good luck and thank you. Well, everybody, thank you so much for your attention. I hope you can do this well, and good luck. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Goodbye.